Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Legends Invitationals. Here we go. There they are. Hello, my fellow Latter-day Saints. Kenzie Retro here. Welcome back to F1 2019. Last time I made my debut in Formula 2, went on to win the championship, taking out my rival, smug-faced Butler. But nevertheless, there you go. Legends, Senna vs. Prost. Complete any three Senna vs. Prost invitational events to unlock the 1990 McLaren MP45B and 1990 Ferrari F190. It's a bit underwhelming. I was hoping we were going to get scenarios that were based around their career-defining moments during their rivalry. But nevertheless, here we go. Of course I'm going to go as Ayrton Senna. Monaco. Good starting place. Six times Ayrton Senna won at this circuit. I believe it was six. And indeed it was six.
Now, while today's classic exhibition event has no direct impact upon the Formula One World Championship, you better believe that with their reputations on the line, the drivers down there are still hungry to show that they've got what it takes to get a win.
Race on the track. Checkpoint challenge. Okay, stop. Back in 1988, Senna managed to out-qualify Alain Prost, his teammate, by 1.5 seconds. He was so far in the lead, he pretty much had the win wrapped up. And then, round about here, Senna crashed into the wall and was out of the race. There he is. One of my favourite Monaco Grand Prix from years gone by is back in 1992. Senna at McLaren, Nigel Mansell at Williams. Williams was so much faster than anyone else yet despite Senna being on warm tyres and Mansell being on a fresh set of rubber, Mansell just could not find a way past. Oh! Cover the target distance, and there we go. And there we go. One down, seven to go. On to Italy now. There's an overtake challenge, easy enough.
Hello again, and thank you for joining us today for one of the few events this year that won't have a critical impact on the World Championship. So maybe we can all relax just a little bit more and enjoy the action from this wonderful field of historic cars.
Overtake 10 opponents, 5 minutes 10. Easy enough. Let's go. Now, the McLaren MP44 back in 1988 was the most dominant car in Formula One history. Winning 15 of the 16 races they had that season. But the thing to remember, but the key thing to remember is that at this very circuit in 1988, neither McLaren finished the race. What a driver to be. As soon as you saw that, the glow of that yellow helmet from Senna, you were just like, nope, I'm out of here. Just like that, for example. I've got left work to do as well. and the McLaren MP44 was a pre-order bonus for F1 2018 last year, or the F1 2017. It would have been F1 2018, yeah. Because the classic cars got introduced back into F1, back into the game in F1 2017 after making their debut in F1 2013. Which was the game that I started my F1 career in. And now it's time to come down the arch rival Al Ancon. It started off as a harmonious working relationship between the two, but after Monaco, it seems to be the greatest rivalry in Formula 1 history would start to build. And there we go. Granted, I am on the medium difficulty, but still. Easy as that. It was after Monaco back in 1988 that the seeds for the rivalry did begin. And many F1 fans like myself regard it as the greatest rivalry in Formula 1 history. And it's easy to see why. And the Senna documentary is one I highly recommend you watch as well, because it goes into great detail on that incredible rivalry, both on and off. Brazil. And of course I've got to go with Senna here. Now, traditionally this would be towards the end of the season. Now, but back when Senna was racing, it was the first race of the season.
Here we are then, the calm before the storm, as we wait for this field of iconic cars to burst into life for the historic invitational event today. I'm delighted to have the opportunity to be here and welcome along to all of you at home as well. So grab a cup of tea and get ready as our competitors make their final preparations.
Now, at time of recording this, folks, I'm in the process of uploading my F1 2019 debut, my first F1 2019 video. Here we go, finishing first place. easy enough. Now, Senna, while he had a lot of success, one of the main goals he wanted was to win his home race. He had come close on several occasions, but he never officially achieved that until 1991. When he had his car stuck in sixth gear throughout the climax of the race. And he was at a stage where he was so physically and mentally exhausted from all the driving he did that he he didn't have any feeling in his arms. His arms had gone numb, that he was having spasms in them. But he persevered and still managed to lift his first trophy. Plus, the Brazilian flag. And to say that he was happy about winning that day is a bit of an understatement. I'll be getting these invitational scenarios out of the way before heading to career mode. I've done the free practice in Australia, so unlike previous seasons where I've done the free practice as well as the qualifying and the race, we've just received the qualifying and the race. I believe Senna won twice around this circuit. I might be wrong on that one. I'm pretty sure he won again in 93. Which again, in an inferior McLaren compared to the dominant Williams of 92 and 93. You know, as you can see, compared to the steering wheels of today, these steering wheels were so much simpler. These legend scenarios will be a separate video to my career mode video, but they'll still be in the same playlist. So don't worry about the F1 2019 videos being in different places. They will be in one dedicated playlist. Thank you. three up. And that's three. There you go. And I shall show you that right now. Showroom. Classic. Ah, 1982. The year McLaren made their debut in Formula One. They've been in longer. Oh, 1966, my mistake. 82 was when was Keke Rosberg that won the title. For Williams, interestingly. Now, who would have been in that McLaren back then? John Watson and Niki Lauda, of course. Racing round four that season. It's interesting. But there it is, the MP44 in all its glory. Minus the Marlboro sponsorship, but that would mean this game would go from a Peggy 3 to a Peggy 18 because of its association with tobacco. And tobacco sponsorships aren't exactly allowed anymore. There it is, the MP45B. Oh my word, that sheet. Now as you can see, there's Senna's name at the top. And of course, Alain Prost as well. The 1991 MP46. That was the car that Senna won his first Brazilian Grand Prix in. And actually, no. Well, it looked like, hang on a second. 1951 Grand Prix. Alain Prost was on pole position, and indeed, Ayrton Senna did win. Senna did win in 92-93. Did he win in 92? No, he didn't. That honour went to Riccardo Patrese. It's Speaking of Williams, there they are. FW14B. There's the FW18 from 96. The Damon Hill one is won the championship. Fantastic car that. The MP413. Mika Häkkinen. FW25. Another one of the most dominant cars in F1 history, the F2004. An incredible piece of machinery. Shell, Vodafone, Fiat. Nevertheless, let's go back here and continue these scenarios. Time attack. Gonna stick with Senna.
Welcome to today's invitational event, where some of the world's finest drivers will be treating us to a special exhibition of some of the sport's most iconic cars.
Here we go. French Grand Prix at the Paul Ricard circuit. So many different layouts to this track, it's hard to keep count. And Senna was still here. Next year he'd be celebrating his 60th birthday. Of course, for those who don't know about what happened to Ayrton Senna, he had an accident at San Marino Grand Prix in 1994. Just a few hours after the race, where we also had Michael Schumacher winning his third race in a row. This was a fully manual gearbox they had back in the day as well. These cars. Blah blah blah, Jeff, quiet, I know what I'm doing. We'll be right back. That's us halfway.
Putting aside for a moment the excitement of the Formula One World Championship, today's historic Invitational makes a nice change of pace. It not only serves as a way to revisit some of the best cars in the sport's history, but also gives the drivers the opportunity to show off their skills and demonstrate to the crowds exactly why their reputations are so well deserved.
just shy of 11 kilometres. But a pass is still a pass. Metres away. You know what? I'm feeling generous to the Ferrari fans. Let's have a go in the Ferrari.
Now, while today's classic exhibition event has no direct impact upon the Formula One World Championship, you better believe that with their reputations on the line, the drivers down there are still hungry to show that they've got what it takes to get a win.
I will say this, guys. I preferred Senna over Prost. The McLaren sound to the Ferrari sound, comparing their two cars over the 1990 season, but again, that's just me. We'll be right back.
Hello again, and thank you for joining us today for one of the few events this year that won't have a critical impact on the World Championship. So maybe we can all relax just a little bit more and enjoy the action from this wonderful field of historic cars.
Yeah, I definitely prefer the McLaren sound over the Ferrari sound. Round La Force. Now, this is a bit that F1 fans often get confused about. The bottom part is eau rouge, the top, that's radial action. A moment that broke the F1 internet fan base, and it's easy to see why, but nevertheless, here we go. We had prior to the 2014, the start of the hybrid era. That was pretty scary, going at 150 plus miles an hour, 160 plus miles an hour up eau rouge and radial. interesting fact about the circuit, the current circuit we have for Belgium is half of its original length. But 7 kilometers long right now, which would have meant it'd be over 14 kilometers if the original layout was used. Well, that went about as well as I would have expected. Here we go. One invitational event to go. And oh, goody gumdrops! Japan. Of course. Of course it would be Japan. A place that is no stranger to controversy when it comes to the rivalry between these two incredible drivers.
Here we are then, the calm before the storm, as we wait for this field of iconic cars to burst into life for the historic invitational event today. I'm delighted to have the opportunity to be here and welcome along to all of you at home as well. So grab a cup of tea and get ready as our competitors make their final preparations.
I mean, let's put it this way, for 4 years running at this circuit, the championship was decided at this circuit, involving McLaren. Senna won in 88 despite a bad start. Mm-hmm. 1989. Both Senna and Prost collided at the Casio Triangle. Prost retired, but Senna continued. Demonstrate what happened at the Casio Triangle, but then I was able to notice something else. A crash between Senna and Prost at 1990. So back to 89, Senna got disqualified for taking the escape road, which his team tried to appeal, so that wasn't possible. From there, Prost became the champion. If Ross failed to finish, Senna would be the champion. And so, at the first corner, the following lines of commentary came out. And Senna sprints away, but Alain Prost has taken the lead. It's happened. Alain Prost has taken the advantage. Senna is trying to go through on the inside, and it's happened immediately. This is amazing. Senna goes off at the first corner, but what has happened to Prost? He has gone off too. Down to the pole position being on the dirty side of the track. And at that first corner, Senna ensured that Prost failed to finish. And the rest of these things is history. There we are, folks. We've got an hour's worth of footage with these two iconic cars, with two iconic drivers. And there we go. Now there's only one question left. Who's up for some career mode?